Guys, tomorrow is the second drop of God Tier. Something for Christmas. Follow God Tier right now. Don't miss out. Leave your email address. We're dropping tomorrow.
Today, I'm reacting to the watch collection of the true winner of the Ballon d'Or, Robert Lewandowski.
Robert Lewandowski.
This man deserved a Ballon d'Or. He was robbed. He was robbed last year.
Lionel Messi.
I cannot be like, okay, the world is disaster and I can do this. No, I know that I have to push myself and trying to be, to growing quickly. That will be difficult, but I know that I have to be stay strong.
What a player, mate, and what a watch as well. What you see here is the Patek Philippe Aquanaut 5167A, a full steel Aquanaut. No, I had the 5164A as well in steel, but mine had the travel time. Mine was the more fancy version. I have already told the story about the Aquanaut in the previous video. Do you want me to tell that again, or?
Give me a brief history, quick.
The Aquanaut was first introduced in 1997. Yes, that's done.
That's pretty good.
The Patek Philippe Aquanaut that Robert is wearing here is worth between $60,000 and $62,000. Oh. That's nice. He loves his Pateks. What a watch. 5980. Blue dial. I need to pee. Can I pee first?
Yes.
And then we'll resume with this watch. I promise I'll come back.
I'll be waiting for you, darling.
Oh, yes, baby. This is the Patek Philippe Nautilus. 5980. 1AR. And you know where AR stands for?
It stands for white gold. And rose gold or steel and rose gold?
So if a 5167A
is
steel, it can't be white gold.
Steel and rose gold.
So A stands for steel, R stands for rose gold.
Yes.
This is one of the only 5980s that's still in production today. A watch that is quite well known due to our good friend Conor McGregor. I think that this must have been his first Nautilus, but it's class to see this on the Polish Prince. Watch is worth between $130,000 and $135,000. So if you can put that on a counter, do the other one on the counter as well, because we haven't done a count in a while. But I have the feeling Roberto is gonna have a few more pieces.
Well, I hope so. We've only
done two. Yeah, all the way. That was a short video. Listen, scoring goals allows you to buy nice watches, and that one, this is f***ing unbelievable. It could be, by the way, two versions or two types of watches. Because I'm colorblind, I can't see the f***ing dial. Is it purple or blue? It could be blue.
Definitely purple.
But it could be blue. And if it was blue, this would be the Royal Oak, which was introduced in 2012. The extra thin tourbillon reference number 26510 in full steel, which would be worth between $160,000 and $170,000. But if it was the purple version, it would be something extremely special. It would be the reference number 62522ST. Tourbillon, the newer generation of the Tourbillon Extra Thin in a 41mm case of Audemars Piguet Royal Oak. This watch is worth between $280,000 and $300,000, and you know why it's worth more?
Why?
Because it's newer and it's rare, it's more rare. I have been very fortunate to see this watch in person, to be honest. And it's an absolute belter of a watch. I had the yellow gold version, the BA, look at that. I sold that for £100,000, mate. Watch is worth double now.
This is like a recurring theme with your seals.
I make other people a lot of money. You see this, right? Talking about recurring theme. See this watch? I had one of the first ones that ever arrived in the UK. You know how much I sold that at? £6,500.
What are they worth?
14, 15K. It's f***ing bunkers. Look at all these, by the way. This is extremely rare, mate. Because it's the first time I have ever seen every single new color Oyster Perpetual combined together. We're actually gonna sell this as a set. Every single watch is brand spanking new. These six babies should always stick together. We can't break up the family. If you're interested in buying the full f***ing set of Oyster Perpetuals, first link in the description. That's unbelievable. 5968A. You know what that means?
White gold.
Anal. No! It doesn't mean white gold!
Steel.
Jesus Christ, what's wrong with you? 5968A. A full steel Aquanaut with a chronograph and the orange strap. This is a very rare watch. The 5968A was first introduced in 2019. It came in two variations. Class. A watch that is massively popular today. And I would value the watch with the orange strap between $150,000 and $160,000. We're approaching next level money for Lewandowski.
Lewandowski.
Goals get gash.
Robert Lewandowski, I must say, Robert, looking dashing. Did you not discuss your clothing before you came here?
I found it, this suit like this, and I say, okay, I take this one.
Yeah, very nice. We appreciate the effort.
UEFA Champions League forward of the season. No, Ballon d'Or winner 2020 and 2021. Hashtag fight for Robert Ballandorski.
You're going the wrong way, though, because we read left to right.
Hashtag fight for Robert Ballandorski. 2020 and 2021. Oh my God. He also has the f***ing watch in rose gold. For the people that have never watched my videos or have never seen this watch coming across on my channel, please subscribe. This is the Patek Philippe Nautilus 5980, which was first introduced in 2006, making this the first ever chronograph Patek Philippe has ever produced in a Nautilus, but also the first ever integrated chronograph Patek Philippe has produced fully in-house, which make this watch very special. The Patek Philippe 5980 1R is worth between $240,000 and $250,000.
I remember the situation because I got the question if I can sit with the same table with Cristiano and Lionel Messi. I say I can invite them both to my table to eat maybe the dinner.
This is the remaster of Audemars Piguet's most beautiful and most famous chronograph they've ever produced. This watch is actually on my Christmas list. The watch is worth between $50,000 and $55,000. The retail price is a little bit higher, but this is a limited edition remaster. There were 500 pieces produced of this watch. Absolutely spectacular. I'm absolutely and utterly in love with this watch. It's a combination of steel and rose gold. Absolute cracker of a watch. One day I will add this to my collection. This is the Audemars Piguet Royal Oak Chronograph reference number 26331 in full steel. And I have exactly that dial configuration. This chronograph module is not made by AP. It's actually made by a different company called Dubois. And we call this chronograph module the Dubois module. Ridiculously fragile. Like, I have had two of these chronographs in the past and both of them had to go back to AP. Nevertheless, it's one of the most beautiful chronographs I've ever seen in my life. What you see here is the Audemars Piguet perpetual calendar in full ceramic. Black ceramic. Yeah, that's another big one. Like, a perpetual calendar tells you the day, the date, the month, the year. If it's a leap year, yes or no. And it also will tell you the position of the moon if set correctly.
And it's accurate until 2100.
Yes, because 2100 is a leap year, but we're not counting that as a leap year. And as this is a mechanical watch, it doesn't know that. We're actually fooling mechanical watches. This is the Audemars Piguet Royal Oak reference number 26579CE in black, worth between $275,000 and $300,000. Right, we're for sure now above a million. And that proves my point, goals get cash. 5726, 1A. You know I actually have this watch, but then with the discontinued dial, the gray dial. You know I paid £80,000 for that watch. And then the price dropped like a f***ing stone. Ooh. I get shafted either way. It's always the same. Now the watch is creeping up in price again, but the blue dial is the most popular. I have the gray one, unfortunately, but what a f***ing watch. You know what this is called?
What?
This is called an annual calendar. And do you know what an annual calendar does? An annual calendar tells you the day, the date, and the month. The annual calendar is a simplified version of the perpetual calendar, and it was first introduced by Patek Philippe in 1996. Today, the annual calendar is one of Patek Philippe's most used complications. The blue dial is worth between $140,000 and $160,000. That's no dog shit. Oh yeah, by the way, it's made in steel. One of glasses as well. Like, what the f*** were you thinking, Lewandowski? All right.
Man, I'm gonna break my monitor, I swear.
That's not Robert. That's not Robert. Look at the state of it. Look at it. The screws are not even placed correctly. This is disgusting. This is actually disgusting, to be honest. You know what? Lewandowski has no variation in his watch collection. Other than the re-edition of the chronograph, it's all very similar. I think he needs more diversity.
What would you rate his collection then?
I would rate Robert's collection a 7 out of 10.